Hello everyone and welcome back. In today's video, we will learn how to add styles to lists using CSS. Let's say we've got these two lists. One is ordered list and one is unordered list. So CSS allows us to change the list type for HTML list. So right now we've got the style as 1, 2, 3, 4 for the ordered list. Let's try changing that. So this is the code we have. And for the first list, we've got an ID. Let's use that for the styling. So coming to our index.css file, let's paste the ID here. And to change this list style, we've got a property called list style type. So list style and type. So this property accepts multiple values. Say we want the list to be in alphabetical order and uppercase. So we could go something like this. Upper alpha. Let's save it. And as you can see, our list is in alphabetical order. Similarly, if we want it to be lowercase, we could do something like this. Lower alpha. Let's save it. And as you can see, our list is in alphabetical order, just the lowercase. Similarly, say if you want to make it uppercase Roman numerals, so we could do upper Roman. Let's save it. And we've got these Roman numerals. Similarly, if you want it to be lowercase Roman numerals, we could do something like this. So lower and Roman. Let's save it. And we've got these lowercase Roman numerals. Similarly, we can change the list style type for our unordered list. So let's get the ID for that. So let's just copy it from here and paste it. And because it's an ID, so we need to use hash. Again, the same property, list style type. So the default value of unordered list is disk, but we can change it to circle and square. So let's try that. Say circle. And as you can see, our unordered list is these circles. Similarly, we can have it as square. Let's save it. And as you can see, our list items are now square. Now let's try making this list multi-line. So coming back here. So Mercury, let's say lorem ipsum dolor. Let's just copy paste it multiple times. Similarly here. Similarly here. Let's save it. And as you can see, now our list is in two lines. Let's reduce the width, say width 500 pixels. Let's save it. Now, as you can see, our list items are in multiple lines. And these markers, so this first, second, third, etc., these are outside the list. So what I mean is that the text has an indentation from second line onwards. So the second line and third line has a bit of space in the starting. So let's say we don't want that. So we want to get rid of this indentation. Or in other words, we want to get this markers inside the list. So for that, we have another property called list style position. So let's try that. So list style position. Let's say inside. Let's save it. And as you can see, now our list items don't have any indentation and these markers are inside. Let's try changing the type of markers. Say uppercase alpha, let's save it. So as you can see, these markers, they are inside the list items now. Or in other words, that indentation in the second and third line is gone. Now let's say we want to get rid of these markers. We don't want these markers to show. So for that, we can do something like this. So list type type, so it accepts another property called none. So when you give none, so these markers aren't visible anymore. So let's save it. And as you can see, the markers are gone from our unordered list. So also if you notice, our list has a default left padding. So let's remove that as well. Say padding left and 0. And now, as you can see, all the list default styles are gone. So we don't have a marker and we don't have the left padding. That's all for today, guys. If there's something that you did not understand, feel free to drop a comment and we will discuss it. See you in the next video. Bye and take care.